Hello dear students, in the last class I taught about single column cash book. Now we'll see double and triple column cash book. Together I'll show you one problem. What is cash book? Cash book is a book which is containing only the cash transactions. All the receipts on the debit side, all the payments on the credit side. This is what we learned. Now on the same principles we are going to prepare triple column. What is this triple column cash book means? Here we have three columns. One is discount column, second one is cash column, third one is bank column. Whenever we'll find discount transactions are there and bank transactions are there along with cash, then we need to prepare triple column cash book. Only the thing is you have to identify what transaction are having a bank transactions, that transactions identify and just go ahead. So the columns will be like this, triple column cash book as usual, making into two parts. This is debit side and credit side, writing DR and CR, debit, credit. Columns, how many columns will get? Date, particulars, is you know, LF is also you know, three columns, discount, cash, bank, three columns. In the same way, credits are date, particulars, LF, discount, cash, bank. Three columns we got it. One problem will solve it. You'll get clarity. Now, the first transaction here, January 1st, commenced business with 20,000 rupees. Whenever we start business, that will be opening balance. Opening balance will be on the debit side of cash book. So, January 1st. Two balance brought down. Same thing we have done in the single column cash book also. How much is the amount? 20,000, that's the amount we are starting cash now. So we'll write it in the cash column. 20,000. We are not writing anything on the bank column. This is not a bank transaction. And second one is paid into bank. We are paying into bank. What is the journal entry of this transaction? Paid into bank. Bank is the receiver. Debit the receiver, you know. Bank's account data to cash account. This is the journal entry of January 2nd transaction. Bank cash. Bank account data to cash account. Whenever in any transaction, bank and cash together, we are finding an entry, that will be called as contra entry. Contra means bank and cash together in one entry. So this is the contra entry. So how do we post it? Simply just observe it. Bank is on which side? Debit side. So debit side will say to cash, opposite one, debit side. Bank is on the debit side, so debit side, we are writing opposite one is cash, to cash account. Why opposite one? Bank, if you write it doesn't make any sense, it doesn't make any meaning. So that's the reason we'll write the opposite one, then we'll come to know that cash is deposited into the bank. So debit side we are writing cash to cash account. How much is the amount? 1000. Cash in which column we have to write? Bank column. Bank column, because bank transaction we are posting. In the same way, cash is on which side? Credit side. So credit side will write the opposite one. Opposite one is bank. By bank account. Cash, now this is, so we'll write cash amount only, cash column, 1000. In LF column we can mention it C. C means contra entry. Contra entry means two times we are writing same entry, debit side and credit side. Are you getting this? Bank account data to cash account. Bank is debited. So debit side we are writing opposite one cash. But amount should be on the bank column only. In the same credit side, cash is on the credit side. So credit side we are writing opposite bank. But amount should be on the credit side only. So this is one contra entry. Next one, purchased goods for cash. When we are purchasing goods, amount is going out. Purchasing means payment. All the payments will be on the credit side. So we'll write, so previous one date is January 2nd. third one is purchasing. Purchasing is payment. So credit side by purchases account. How much is the amount purchasing? 2000. Payment through the cash. Next, seventh, sold goods for cash. Whenever we are selling goods on cash basis, we are getting cash. So that's a receipt, debit side. Seven, to sales account. How much we are receiving? 5000 rupees cash through the sales. Next, January 9th, received from Ravi 9800 and allowed discount 200. We are receiving from Ravi. Whenever we are receiving, all the receipts on the debit side. So we'll say to Ravi's account. From Ravi we are getting. How much amount we are getting? 9800 we are receiving. And allowing discount. How much is allowing? 200. Discount is 200. Discount column 200 will write. Next, January 12th, cash paid to Mr. X and received discount. When we are paying cash to Mr. X, he is allowing us discount of 100 rupees. Payment we are paying to Mr. X. All the payments will be on the credit side. So January 12th, by to whom you are paying? X. X account. How much you are paying? 7900. He allowed us discount of 100 rupees. Next, 16th, sold goods to Mr. Anil. We are selling to Anil. Is there any cash? No. Cash is not there. Also mentioned to whom we are selling. Anil name is mentioned. It means it is a credit transaction. Credit transaction doesn't appear in the cash book. So we'll ignore it, we'll not consider it. That goes to the sales book. Credit transactions, credit sales will be in the sales book, but not in the cash book. So we'll ignore it. Next, 22nd, cash withdrawn for office use. Whenever we are withdrawing cash from office, cash from office use, cash for office use, from where we are withdrawing? From the bank. What is the entry? We are withdrawing, means we are getting cash. Cash account, we are getting cash. From where we are getting? From bank to bank account. This is the entry of 22nd. Please be careful withdrawing for office use. If it is for personal use, drawings. We'll write by drawings, expenses. We are withdrawing, we'll write it in the bank column. But it is for the office use. Whenever you are withdrawing for office use, the entry will be cash account returned to bank account. This is the entry. Whenever you find cash and bank together in one entry, that's a contra entry. Just like on second entry. On second also paid into bank. Bank returned to cash. Cash and bank is there. So it was a contra entry. Here also, withdrawing for office purpose. That is cash account added to bank account. Cash, bank, both together in one entry. This is also a contra entry. How do you post it? Cash is on which side? Debit side. So 22nd, cash is on debit side. What do you write? Opposite one. To bank account. Which side will write? Cash side only. Amount is 750 cash side. This is contra entry. And bank is on which side? Credit side. So credit side, bank is credit side, opposite one, means cash will write by cash account. How much is the amount? 750. Cash account which side? Bank side will write. So this is contra entry. Then last one, 31st, rent paid to landlord, 4000 we are paying to landlord. So it's a payment. 31st, by rent account. How much we are paying? 4000 we are paying. That's all. We have posted everything. Same like single column cash book. We close the accounts. Remember always, discount should not be balanced. Same amount, whatever is there, that simply you write it in the outer column. So here we have discount of 200 and on the credit side 100 rupees. Now cash, which side is more? Cash column is this, debit side, and credit side cash column is this. Debit side is more, 20,000, 25,000, 50, 15, 10, 15, and 35,550. So same amount we'll write it on the credit side, 35,550. From 35,550, if you remove all this cash, whatever we get, that will be the balance carried down. 31st by balance carried down. So how much we'll get? 35,550 minus, total this amount, 900 is here, 900, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 plus 7, 14. Zero. 20,650 is the balance. So we'll write balance carried on 20,650. This is about the balancing of the cash. Now, what about the bank? Bank also debit side is more. Debit side is more, 1,000. We'll write 1,000 here. Credit side is 750. 1,000 minus 750, 250. 250 is the balance carried on. So that would be the opening balance of the next month. Next month is February 1st. Two balance brought down, 20,650 and 250. That's all. This is about the triple column cash book. Please remember once again, triple column cash book, you must be very careful about the contra entry, discount. Whenever we are getting an amount, discount is fitted there, that will post it. Whenever you are paying, discount if you are receiving, then also that should be posted in the discount column. Posting of discount is not a problem. Only main thing is that you have to remember contra entry. When do we get contra entry? Only two times. One is amount deposited into the bank. Whenever you are depositing into the bank, what is the entry? Bank account attached to cash account. Means bank and cash is there. It's a contra entry. Second one is that whenever you are withdrawing for office purpose, not personal, withdrawing amount for office purpose, then that will be a contra entry. Withdrawing means what is the entry? Cash account attached to bank account. Once again, it's a contra entry. Where cash and bank together, if you find, that's a contra entry. Simple. If you remember, this triple column cash book is quite easy. You can do it. Hope you understood. And do practice more problems from your test book. Refer more books. Concept is the same. Understand it. Go ahead. For more commerce and management videos, stay tuned with me. Do share these videos. And any doubts, you can mention in the downside of the video. Enhance your career. Develop yourself. Good luck.